And then we'll talk about intracavernosal injection. So this is just another way to give that medication that we just talked about in terms of putting in the urethra. This is a tiny needle. You put it in the side of the penis. It delivers the medication to the erectile tissue. The erectile tissue is actually connected in the middle by a thin septum. So you only have to inject one side, and that medication works on all of this tissue to increase blood flow. This medication, like all the others, is used on demand before sexual activity. There are some guys that are fine putting a needle in the penis. There are others that are like, look, doc, there's no way I'm doing that. And that's fine. That's why we have all these different options you can choose for yourself. We think about side effects. It's going to be penile pain and burning, especially when we use the medication called Edex or Caverject. That medication is alprostadil. Can cause priapism, so that's that erection that's painful, that lasts too long. The injections can cause this. And so you really got to start at a low dose and slowly work your way up. You don't want to start at a high dose because that can be problematic and necessitate an emergency room visit. Can cause hypotension and headache if absorbed systemically. And then it can cause scar tissue to develop in the penis. So if you're someone who's coming in who already has some scar tissue, perhaps already has some penile curvature, I typically steer away from the penile injections. Other considerations, cost. We used to have a sort of like a specialty program contract where we could get it for a max out of pocket, $25. That contract went away. And so the cost is variable depending on insurance. And this plays into the decision-making, whether or not someone can afford the medication. We do recommend a first-time in-office administration to show you how to do the injections, to make sure you tolerate the medication okay. In terms of injection frequency, you can't use it, you know, any sooner than really every 48 hours. So if you're interested in having sexual intercourse on a daily basis, you know, this isn't going to be your jam on a daily basis. You do need to refrigerate this medication if you're using one of the compounded where we put in multiple medications. And the other consideration is if you're using something like bimix, trimix, quadmix, super quadmix, where you put multiple injectable medications together, just figuring out which compounding pharmacy we're going to get it from and costs associated with that.